What's up, family and friends? How are you? I hope you're doing well. I welcome you to this live broadcast, and I want to share with us what I titled Knowledge is Very Important. Knowledge is very important to you as a man and to us as a people. Knowledge is very important. Knowledge is the greatest, not love. Knowledge is the greatest. And the greatest knowledge is the knowledge of yourself, knowledge of self. When you know yourself, you will be unfit to be a slave. As they say, Frederick Douglass said, knowledge makes man unfit to be a slave. And I will tell you more about that. When you have knowledge, people will not be taking advantage of you, will not be losing. Ignorance costs you a lot. Ignorance, yes. Remember, people say what you don't know will kill you. So you're not even costing you. You say it will cost you your life. Ignorance will cost you your freedom. Ignorance will cost you your liberty. Your ignorance will cost you your peace, peace of mind. You see, many people are not having peace of mind or rest of mind in their marriage, in their family, in their business, and what they are doing, because they are ignorant of what they are doing. They are ignorant about that. That's why. But when you know better, of course, you deal better, you live better, and you begin to see the benefit. You begin to see profit in whatever you are doing. I remember when I was in Alaba International, so my ex-in-law that time, he was a rich man, Comestar. Those of you that is familiar, you know, with Alaba International, Comestar. Yeah, so I went to him one time and I wanted him to invest in a business. Although I'm doing business with him, you know, working under him. Then he said to me, no, he only invests money in the business he knows very well about. You see, knowledge is very important. And that man is bastardly rich today. You know, that's one of the guy, advanced the kidnapper kidnapped and demanded for $1 million. And he paid for it, $1 million. A man living in Nigeria pay a ransom of $1 million to be released by the kidnappers. So for you to know what I mean, that man is wizard in business. That's the man I met, and I said, listen, some people are wizard in business. That's, they know what they're doing. And when you know somebody that know what they're doing in business, of course they make it. If you don't know what you are doing in any business you are, you'll be struggling there, you'll be struggling here, you'll be struggling, or that somebody else will be making money off of your ignorance. If you know how to fix a car, do you think you will be taking it to a mechanic and paying all that money you are paying, especially like in America here? You know how much a mechanic will charge you just for working on your car? Maybe you walk all the time, but just one day you take your car to a mechanic. Mechanic charge you $700, $800 for workmanship. Workmanship. You know how long you walk to make that $500 or $800? But you pay it because that's the car you use to make money. So you have to fix it. The car is making money, of course. If you know how to treat yourself when you are sick, do you think doctors will be taking a dime from you? No, you won't be going to a doctor. It's out of ignorance. If not for wickedness of men, it's in all of us who should be sharing our knowledge free of charge, not monetizing them, not like when you become something, you begin to charge people too much. You can treat people then whatever that they have to appreciate your good work. They will, because you will, in your time of need, you will go to them also. But now everything is money, because the foundation of humanity has been shattered. But no condition is permanent. Knowledge is restoring us. Knowledge is very important. If you know that person you're married, if you know that man or that woman you're married, do you think you'll be having marital problem as you're having today? No. If you know that person, there'll be no issue for divorce or disengagement or what, or marital problems, all that thing we are going through in marriage is all attached to ignorance. When you know better, you live free. That's what knowledge does. When I was ignorant, I was a Christian. Because fear and ignorance will make you religious. Of course. I was ignorant of myself. So I thought I was a son of Abraham. I thought I'm a child of God by faith in Jesus Christ. Why I am above Jesus? Jesus never existed. I am useful. Jesus is useless. I am real. Jesus is not real. But ignorance made me believe that Jesus is my Lord and Savior. Jesus is my shepherd. Jesus is my sheep. All that nonsense. Even when I was a new convert, I remember in those days in Kaduna, because I became a new convert, that's the second time, in Kaduna, that's when I became a minister in Kaduna State in Nigeria. That was 1993. Some of you watching me, you weren't born then yet. So, and it was four of us as ministers. So we used to gather every morning. We live together, of course. We used to gather every morning then to have a fellowship, you know, pray, fast. If it's the day we're going out for evangelism, we go out for evangelism. We don't have church our own, but we have ministry. So we go every Sunday, we go to Winners Chapel, Kaduna, when Kaduna was the headquarters. The international headquarters. So there is this guy, four of us. So when it's meal time, you know, they share things or they share labor according to our age. So because I was ignorant that I was older than this guy, I thought by me looking at him, I thought maybe I am the youngest among them. And I was living like that, obediently. Living in ignorance, putting somebody that is below me above me as regard to age. So until the day I found out I am older than him, and by that time the ministry is no longer, all of us have gone our different ways. So one day I think Yereba was having either conference or ministry conference on that, or either Yereba or Idahosa. So I met the guy. That's when I know his age. I am some years older than him. But at least he enjoyed that privilege while I was suffering as somebody that is younger than him. So ignorance costs us a lot. Even today, myself too, ignorance is costing me. But knowledge is very important. That's why I will not give up seeking for knowledge, going for knowledge. That's what we must be doing, seeking and spreading knowledge. Religion hates knowledge. And I will use Christian religion as an example with the Bible. The Bible tells us that God created man and put man in the garden and forbade man from knowledge. Knowledge is the tree God forbade man eating. Knowledge. He wants them to obey his law. Knowledge will free you from bondage of any law. Yes. You see, in America, some people pay unnecessary tickets just because police write it. But some people, they go to court because they know the law. They know their rights. They fight it and the judge strike it out. They walk out free. Of course, it costs them their time instead of their time and the money, as the police would have taken it. Or police make government to take it from him. So God put Adam and Eve in the garden, forbade them from knowledge, and said, "If don't eat this, the day you eat it, you will die." That's a religious threat. That's how religion threatens people with death. If you do this, you will die. If you don't do this, you will die. Like, but when you know you cannot die, you are eternal, you will trash all those commandments and know that that God that gave you that commandments is silly, is weak and useless. Because if that God exists, he's not supposed to give you any commandment. He will make you to live like him. He said he created his own image and likeness. So if God is not under the law, why do he put you under the law? If you are like your father is not under any law, and you are living under a law, you are stupid, you are a stupid child. If God is not under the law, then why are you under the law? The God that forbade them from knowledge, then in Hosea chapter 6:4, he said that my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Of course, Adam and Eve were useless for lack of knowledge in the garden. Adam was running naked with like every other animal in the garden because of lack of knowledge. Adam don't know how to sew even fig trees together and cover his nakedness because of lack of knowledge. Man didn't know all that because God forbade man from knowledge. The day man knew, acquired knowledge, God chased man away. Of course, knowledge will always separate you from slaves. Knowledge will separate you from slavery. Knowledge will separate you from bondage. That's what knowledge does. He said, let me chase them away. I don't want them to live like me. I don't want them to live forever. And that is the God many of my people still believe in. That is the God many of my people still say he loves them. Anyone that forbids you from knowing the truth don't love you. People that love you will tell you the whole truth. They will give you the knowledge you need. That's why when you meet somebody in relationship or in marriage, you want to be with that person, you say you want to know about them. Tell me about yourself. They ask you, what do you want to know? You say, I want to know everything. Tell me about yourself. Even when they tell you all that, maybe on the first date, you will still learning them. You want to know everything because no person will tell you everything about themselves just for some days or some weeks or some months because you say you love them. No, they stand with one leg first. They're not going to put the two legs down until they know you very well because of they are not virgin, of course. They are not kids. They have experienced a lot of heartbreak, as they claim. No person can break my heart. I don't believe in that, somebody breaking your heart. You are the one that break your own heart. Because you put somebody over your life. You think without that person you cannot live. God forbade Adam from acquiring knowledge of themselves, that they are naked. He said, the day you eat of this fruit tree, you will die. The day they ate it, they did not die. Their eyes open, as the wise serpent said. The wise serpent said, help man to gain knowledge. Another thing religion will do to you, they will tell you something without giving you details. And that's what makes religion dangerous. When God tell Adam, and if, remember I'm talking about Bible God, I know there is no, God is not real, no God is real, no God. Whether it's Yoruba God, Igbo God, Hausa God, Christian God, Muslim God, Jewish God, whatever you call that God is not real. You are real. If you're a man, you are God. If you're a woman, you are goddess. We are not gods. We are gods and goddesses. We are not homosexuals. Okay? We are male and female. We have opposite sex. And we have fun together. God only told them, don't eat of this fruit, this tree. The day you eat it, you will surely die. That's what he said. Of course, nobody wants to die, so they stay away from the tree. They did not even look at the tree. God refused to give them detail, but he gave them commandment and the punishment that will follow it if they eat it. But when the wise serpent came, he gave them detail. he gave them some details, not even all the details. Then what the Bible says, said, then the woman looked at the tree. He began to see beyond what God and serpent said. He saw that the tree is good. And the fruit is able to make one wise. How? She gained more knowledge. She ate it and gave to her husband because she found out they cannot die. God lied that the serpent was saying the truth. That fruit will not, knowledge will not kill you. I listened to one Igbo song on Spotify, and I see the nonsense that guy sang, and you see our people buy that nonsense. He said, of course, when you get knowledge, you know there is no God, there's no Almighty God. It's ignorant people that still celebrate God or praise God or worship God or believe in God. When you get knowledge, you will not worship, because you will know you are not born to worship. You are born to live. No God, you will know no God created you. So why will you worship somebody that did not give birth to you or create? If you must worship, worship your parents. But I worship nothing. I worship no one. Because we are in this together. It's our race, human race. We don't own each other. We are not properties. But ignorance will make you a property, like a slave. A slave is a property to another person. So when you don't have knowledge, you become a property. And people can use you and dump you. They can use you and enrich themselves. Just as you see the pastors are following the steps of God in the Garden of Eden to keep people in ignorance. They don't want you to know, because they know when you know, you will stop coming to them. You will stop consulting them. You know that you are even better than their God. Then if you are better than their God, you don't need their services. You don't need anything from them, whether it's blessing or curse. You don't need them. You begin to live free. When you gain knowledge, you become unfit to be a slave. You become unfit to be a member of any religion. You become unfit to be under any God. You become unfit to be under any law made to keep you down. You begin to live a better life. God failed to give them details. The same thing the pastors are doing today, following the steps of their master, whom they call Jehovah, Yahweh, Allah, or Jesus. He said, if you eat it, you will die. He failed to give them detail for them to remain servants, slaves, to a law they're supposed to be above. Of course, man is above every law, because every law is made by some men. No God above man make any law. No God is above any man. When you know yourself, you live better. You will no longer be living in bondage. You will no longer be vulnerable to the lies and deceptions everywhere. You no longer be fallen by what people wrote in the book, whether the book is a million years old or just be written recently. You will no longer be tied down by or be limited by their content, because you know better now. When you know you are wearing original shoe, it doesn't matter what any other person is talking. You see, you walk different. You walk better than person that wearing fake shoe. Of course, knowledge makes you bold. Knowledge makes you free. Knowledge of the truth. Knowledge. When you acquire knowledge, you acquire power. Knowledge brings profit. Knowledge brings freedom. Of course, knowledge brings victory. When you say somebody has won something, it's the person that knows something. Like if there is war, The people that defeat other people is people that know better. Especially when they deceive you to believe in nonsense. Like when they know you are weak points, then they will punch you very well and beat you up. And they say they defeated you. So ignorance makes you a victim, but knowledge makes you victorious. Somebody scammed me some months ago, right? Because I was ignorant. On the phone, somebody scammed me, just take $200, just like that. But people that know, I saw a clip like, just like that today. The police woman know the trick. He said, okay, tell me my address. Had it been, I know that I supposed to ask that. But because I just think, oh, if I see any phone number that is Apple online, it's Apple. So I'm calling for Apple. I'm calling Apple for a refund of my money. And I fell. I was calling for them to refund me my about $600. Then this person scammed me $200 out of it. Ignorance. So I want you, whoever you are or wherever you are, to know the truth. Because when you know the truth, I mean factual truth, nobody will keep you in bondage anymore. Nobody will be toiling with you. You will not be afraid of cause. You will not be afraid of all this threat. Is somebody telling me now God will do this to me or Jesus will do this to me? No, that person is kidding. Because I know beyond that. I know. I used to be a preacher, so I know it's trash. And now I know that Jesus never existed. Jehovah, Allah, Yahweh, Jesus, all of those characters they gave to us that we should fear or worship or respect, they are trash, but we exist. Knowledge is very important. When you gain knowledge, you gain mastery. But when you lack knowledge, you remain and die a slave. Don't die a slave. Wake up and live your life. Life is good. Don't make it bad because of your ignorance. Ignorance is not good for you. It will cost you even your life. But knowledge will make you free and bring you a lot of profit. So go for knowledge. And I encourage you to seek and spread knowledge. Know about that faith you claim to have. Know about religion you claim to belong to. I want you to know. Don't believe. People still asking me, what do you believe now? I believe nothing. If there is anything that exists, I want to know it. If God exists, I want to know God. When I mean know, I want to see, I want to feel, I want to touch. That's what I mean. So I've arrived at working place. So have fun and keep doing a great job.